George, it's been a strange old few months for you, from a professional point of view, hasn't it? Back in Derby, back in February, you pick up that ankle injury against Derby, and you know it looks like it's season over. And then obviously a global pandemic kicks in. I know you're back to finish the season. It's been a strange few months.
Well, where to start really? From picking up the injury, being in the worst mood ever, knowing that I wouldn't play again for the rest of the season. And then obviously things happen with the coronavirus, and it give me like a glimpse of hope, personally, to think, oh, like, you never know what could happen. Like, I might be back before, like, to finish the season off. And then, obviously, a few months down the line, I'm back fully fit, 9 games to go. You know, it's strange. It's honestly, I can't explain it. Like, it's just the weirdest feeling ever. And now I'm back fully fit, as I just said, and raring to go, and can't wait to finish these 9 games, yeah.
Yeah. And so over the last few months, you've been busy with your rehab. What does rehab in lockdown look like?
Well, it's tough, you know. At the start, I was going in to see the physios like maybe 3 times a week, getting bits done, doing my gym work and stuff. And it's hard. It's mentally so hard. And then after maybe like a week or so, everything got a bit worse with the coronavirus and stuff. So I had to then do what I was doing at home. So I got all the gym stuff put in the garden, which is good, which has helped me a lot, because obviously I didn't have anything. But doing it in the garden is tough. That again is mentally tough. Just trying to motivate yourself. Like when you're at home, you're comfortable. Like you wake up, you might sit on the sofa for a bit, and then you're like, oh god, like I gotta go and do stuff now. So it's hard to do it by yourself, but you got to do it, you know. And once you do it, you feel good after you've done it. It's just getting going, I guess. And then I started to, when it settled down a little bit, I started to go in 3 days a week again. Things get tougher and tougher when you do stuff in the gym. I've put my body through a lot of stress, if you like, to try and get back as quickly as I can. I remember days in the gym, like nearly fainting because I've been working so hard, doing my rehab and stuff. So it does take a lot out of you, but the end goals, you know, it's just, if you do it properly in the gym, the end goals are just, you know, it's the best thing for you, and you have to do it. Because if you don't, then you're behind, and if you're behind, you don't play. It's been really tough, to be honest. It's been really tough, but again, now I'm sitting here fit, like ready to play and stuff. It's all worth it. It's all worth it.
Yeah, every session, I suppose, every gym session that you completed, you were one step closer to a potential return. I suppose that was the way you're thinking it, and being in the position you are today.
Yeah, 100%. 100%, and now I'm raring to go. Like, I feel good. I've got no problems in terms of my ankle. It feels really strong. I'm grateful for all the help that I've had from the physios, the doc, just everyone around the club has helped me get into the best shape I possibly can physically, and also having help mentally as well from conversations I've had with people and things like that. So I'm in the best place I possibly can be at the moment. Yeah. So I completed my rehab literally like 2 or 3 days before we was meant to come back in. So when the boys are back in, I just slotted in pretty nicely, really, straight back in with the group. And obviously mentally, that's what I wanted to do. That's, you know, felt really good to be back with the boys, you know, knowing they was back in, I could get back in amongst the group, you know. And obviously, during lockdown and stuff, you miss like the banter, you miss the training, you miss the laughs you have with the boys around the training ground, and you know, you miss that feeling. And it was yeah, it was the best feeling ever to get back amongst the boys, yeah.
It must have been quite difficult kind of coping at first when you were back in February when, you know, you came off, I think, at half-time, wasn't it, against Derby? And then the diagnosis came in, you know, it's season over and your mind is, I'm going to start on pre-season next season, you know. But it must have been difficult at first, George, because you were enjoying the season.
Yeah, it's hard. Like, I've never had a long-term injury before. So when it initially happened, like straight away, I knew I'd done something wrong. Like, I knew the something weren't right. And like coming to grips with that, even before I had the scan, I was thinking, yeah, like this is no good. Like you just know when something bad happens. And at the start, it was hard for me to take. I went in the best of moods, let me tell you that. but like days and like weeks go by, like I had the scan and whatnot. I just had to reset. Like I knew it happened. Like there's nothing I could have done about it, and I just had to try and get on with it, you know. So that's the kind of approach that I took towards it, and just tried to get myself mentally stable again and think, right, let me try and get back as quickly as I can, you know. So that's how it kind of worked out for me. Yeah.
When you look back at your season, well, so far it's, you know, 33 games you've played in, 5 goals. You must be pretty pleased with the way it's gone for you on a personal level.
Yeah, not bad. Yeah. Those are okay stats, I guess. Yeah, they're good. I've played a lot of games, as you said, which is the main thing that I wanted to do. Obviously, breaking through last season, playing 25 odd games. I wanted to improve that this season and get as many as I could. And you said about the goals, 5 goals is okay. But obviously, before I got injured, I was looking to top that up, you know, and finish the season as strong as I could. All said and done, that happened, got injured and whatnot, so I thought that was over. But now I've still got a real chance to boost them stats up and kick on when the games start again.
You feel that you've improved under the manager as well, because Steve Cooper was very complimentary about you, particularly early in the season. I recall after the Cardiff game at home, he said, I think the comment was, he wanted you to, you know, become a man. And you felt that you became that after that game, you know. Do you feel that you've grown throughout the season?
Yeah, I agreed with his comments. And before that game, we had a chat, and he was just saying, like, we know you're a good player. You've got a lot of quality attributes and whatnot. But, like, in games like Cardiff, you've got to be mature. You've got to know how to play the game, especially in a derby game kind of thing. And I kind of took that and thought, yeah, I had to think about it, and I had to be very mature in my performance. Like, the stuff that you might do in other games, but like when it comes to a derby, you got to be on point. Like you can't mess about with things and try silly things. You got to be, as I said, mature in your performance. And I took that on board and tried to do it as best as I could. And yeah, I think what he said was obviously very good. And I took that on board and tried to use it in the future games as well. Just tried to be more mature with my performances. And yeah, I think I have done, and I'll try and continue to do so in the future games as well.
From a team perspective as well, 9 games to go, just 3 points off the playoffs.
It's
all to play for. It's very exciting.
Yeah, as a squad, we're excited, we're raring to go. I've had chats and stuff here and there with the boys. I remember speaking to Andre a few days ago after training, and we were just saying, like, we're in a good place, like, everyone's mentally prepared, like, there's so much to play for, and we've got a squad to do it. We've got so much talent and ability in the squad, and we've got a real togetherness that we know, like, if we can start well, get some good results, then, you know, we're going to be ready for it. We're going to be gunning for it, you know. So that's what we want to do. We know where we want to be at the end of the season. That's in the Premier League, you know. So we've got to do everything we can to make sure that we get there.
And preparation's obviously well underway now for Middlesbrough on Saturday. Has it been strange at all? Obviously, with like social distancing and all the safety measures in place, you know, being around the training ground, is it very different now?
Yeah, it's not the same as it was Obviously, there's loads of safety precautions and stuff that we have to respect. But the boys have cultivated very well. Like, there's obviously things that we can't do that we'd normally do in terms of leading up to a game. We still can't use the gym and stuff like that. So, but to be fair to all the staff, like, we've got everything in place that we need to adapt to things like that. And the boys have taken to it very well, to be fair. And we'll definitely be ready for Middlesbrough on Saturday when we start.
Yeah, you mentioned about adapting. A big thing to adapt to for, particularly in the games now, will be obviously playing without any fans. Which will be very strange, won't it? But, you know, it's just something you've got to tackle.
Yeah, I know. It's not going to be the same, you know. But I guess, like, the way I looked at it was, like, when we used to play in the 23s and we used to play at a stadium, like, similar kind of atmosphere, like, there's no fans or whatever. So I guess in that respect, like, you're kind of used to it a little bit, but it's nowhere near the same. Like, you want to be playing in front of fans as much as possible, and the more fans, the better. even going to, like, away grounds and stuff, you enjoy the atmosphere. You're not at home, obviously, in front of your own fans, which is what you want to be doing. But, like, even the away atmosphere and stuff, you still want to be involved in. So obviously, yeah, it's going to be strange, but I guess it's something we're going to have to get used to again, you know. So,
and look, going into the Middlesbrough game, obviously, you put yourself, you're back in the mix now. So that central midfield position, Steve's got a good job picking a midfield there. Obviously, there's Captain Grimesy, you know, Conor Gallagher, yourself, Jan Dander, Pearson Salina. You know, you can keep going, couldn't you, with the competition?
Yeah, and that's good. That's what we want as a squad. We want to be pushing each other, you know. And the more players, the better players we have, the better squad that we're going to be, the more chance we're going to have of picking up 3 points. Obviously, you can use 5 substitutions. So if you've got 5 substitutions and you've got all that talent to pick from, you know, it's going to be tough whoever the manager picks. But, you know, even if you're not starting, it's still a lot to play for. If you're coming off the bench, you know, there's so much opportunity there. And we have to make the most of that. We have to make the most of our squad because, as I said before, we've got a lot of talent in it and ability, and we can really do something this year if everyone's on point, which they will be, because the manager, like, says to us all the time, like, if you're not playing, you have to be ready because you never know what can happen. Like, games change, people get injured. You have to be ready at all times, and that's the kind of mentality that, as a squad, we all have. Like, training's always good. The standard's always high. So, at the end of the day, the manager does have a tough choice to pick a starting 11, but that's what we want at the end of the day.
And from a personal point of view, George, obviously your rehab's been really good during the lockdown. But you've also had some great news yourself and your partner as well.
Yeah. So we're expecting a little one, a little girl. Due September the 5th, I think it is. So, yeah, it's the best news ever. Best news ever. Yeah, can't wait. It's going quick, though. It's going really quick. Like, we found out New Year's Eve. And that is just absolutely flown by. Absolutely flown by. So, before we know it, she'll be here. And, obviously, that'll be a game changer on it. So, really, really looking forward to that, yeah.
So, having grown into a man, as we say, doing the season, you'd be a dad by September.
Yeah, I know. It's crazy. But, yeah, it's life-changing, but it's really good. Like, can't wait. We both can't wait.